Hi friends, welcome back to ECMAScript tutorial series. So last day we discussed about the array destructuring. In this video we are going to discuss about object destructuring. So basically, what is destructuring and why we need this? So very simple, destructuring means to break down a complex structure into smaller parts. Means suppose if I have a large object or large array, and from that things I want to get some values. So how easily we can get that things? Okay, so you can extract any small fragments from object. So in this video we'll discuss about that thing. So let's see some examples so we can understand better. So let's take an object. So suppose I am creating a object, that is user object, and object will look like this. We need to start with this curly braces, and inside here I just say it, suppose name, and name Shomo, that is my name, and then I just want to set my email, that is email equal to shomo@email.com. so it is demo email, shomo@email.com, and let's use the phone. So simply just write random number. So this is my phone, right? And now if I just going to print these things, how we can print this? So simply, if I just want to get the name from this user object, so simply write console log, and from inside just use user dot name, so that we can see the name in this consoling. And if I just want to see the email, so we can get email in this way. So basically this is simple JavaScript concept. Now if I just want to use this concept with the destructuring methods, means if I just want to use the benefits of these things, how we can do this? So instead of these things, if I just write here, suppose let, and here I just define that is name, email and phone, and simply just assign the whole object, and we can get name value directly from here, right? So if I just simply use the name, we can see the name. If I just want to see the phone, simply we are getting the phone, right? That means there is three elements, and also we need to use this three element. Suppose if I just use the age here, so right here age, suppose 30, okay, we cannot get access of age until we create a fourth parameter, suppose age. So now if I just use the age, we can get access of age, right? But if I not provide the value of age, that time if I just going to print these things, how we can get? So this is undefined. So here the thing is, we can define here just like default parameter. So by default I am setting the age equal to 0. So if I not get the value of fourth parameter or age, we can set the default value and we can get the output, okay? So this is very simple concept, okay? Now the one things, so just remove the age. I am taking only three things. Suppose I am getting the phone here. So if I just write here phone and refresh this, we are getting the phone, but I don't want to use direct these things. Suppose this object will come from anywhere or any backend, and we don't want to see the backend key or the backend things, right? So how we can set this? We can set the aliases. So how we can set this? So instead of phone, I just write here the mobile, okay? Now if I just use this mobile here, we can get the output. So we are getting the same output if I write this also. So in this way we can set the aliases also. So this was a simple example with object. Let's use multi-dimensional object. Suppose if I just want to create another object, so just fruit, and inside here I just want to create another. So simply just going to create, suppose fruit one, fruit 1, so just use inside the inverted comma, that is fruit 1, and let's the first fruit name suppose apple, and in this way just create another 2, 3. So right here fruit 2, and then fruit 3, and here right suppose banana, then mango, anything. Okay, so just for example, so right here mango. So how we can access these things? Simple concept. So here instead of these things we are getting the fruit parameter. So if I just simply write here the fruit, and let's console these things, we are getting the full fruit object. So if I just refresh this, we are getting the apple, banana, mango. That means inside the fruit we are getting the full object, right? So how we can get only mango? So simple. So inside the fruit we'll just create another things, that is the fruit 1, fruit 2, fruit 3. So in this way just write this fruit 1, fruit 2, fruit 3. So simple, 3 and 2. I just want to get the value from mango, so this is fruit 3. So we are declaring this as fruit 3. So just copy this and paste here and refresh this. So we are getting mango. So this is very small concept but useful concept. These are using basically any advanced technology for front end, like if I just want to use Vue or React, that time we can get this type of ECMAScript concept. So you will understand that time, right? So keep in mind all those things it will need further. So in our next episode maybe we can start the TypeScripting, and then we can go to the Vue or React, that time all the concept will need, right? So this is all about the object destructuring, and if you have any questions about this video please comment in a below comment section. Next day we are going to discuss about another important things, there's the another features you can say. I am going to discuss about two functions, that is find and find index. Basically it will applicable on the array, so we'll discuss about that things. Okay, so please like and subscribe this channel for upcoming video. Thanks for watching this video, and comment me how you like this tutorial. Bye.